Hi everyone. In test automation, TypeScript is most preferred comparing to JavaScript. In this video, I am going to talk about TypeScript. TypeScriptlang.org is the official website, and here we can see the documentation. TypeScript is developed and maintained by the Microsoft, and of course, it is an open source language. Now, here in the documentation, we can see that TypeScript in 5 minutes. That's pretty cool, right? You can get the overview of a language in just a 5 minutes. Now, the reason is very simple, because TypeScript is, of course, it's an independent language, but it is a superset of JavaScript. That means any valid JavaScript code is also a valid TypeScript code. If I go inside this, here we can see handbook, and here if I go to this basic type, here we can see boolean, number, string, array, null and undefined, and object, right? We already have discussed about this in our JavaScript code. What's new in TypeScript is tuple, enum, any, void, and never. We'll talk about this and we'll discuss this in our upcoming videos. In this video, let us understand why TypeScript is preferred and some of the drawbacks in JavaScript. I cannot say it is a drawback in JavaScript. The language is designed in that way only. So drawback is not an appropriate word here. But I think if I show you the code, probably you will get an idea. Okay. So here I'm going to create a new folder, which is 0 to maybe TS, so TypeScript. And here first let us create a JavaScript file. So here I'm going to say dynamic.js. JavaScript is dynamic programming language, right? That means, let me show you. So here I'm going to say var, maybe some str equal to my name, so Kaushik, right? Now let us log this. So here I'm going to say console.log and str, okay? Now to run this, let me go to my terminal, and here first of all go into the folder, so 0 to TypeScript. And here I'm going to use the node and then followed by the file name, which is dynamic.js. We got the output, right? This is fine. Now I said that JavaScript is dynamic programming language, right? What does it actually mean is, here I can manipulate the value str equal to 5, right? Now if I log this again, str, so here I will get the value as 5. It should be str. And here I'm going to run again, so it should be 5. We are getting the output. So what is the major difference? The difference is, here when we created a variable with str as Kaushik, this is of type string, right? So this is going to be of string type. Now I'm changing the data type to a number data type, right? So this is obviously, this is how JavaScript works. So you can choose any data type, you can declare a variable, and you can do the manipulation as well. But this is going to be a problem in the production sometimes, okay? I'm not talking about the developing side, I'm talking about the testing side. Let me give you an idea about that, okay? Now, let us check the type of this as well. So here I'm going to say type of, and here also I'm going to use the type of. Now, if I run this, so here we can see string and number, right? So that is what dynamic program means. So whenever you are going to declare a variable, it can be of one type, and later on it can be of another type, okay? Now let me create a function here. I'm going to command this, and here I'm going to create a function. So here let's say that we are going to do addition, and here I can say I need two parameters, which is a and b. So here I'm going to return a plus b. Cool? Yes. Now let us log this. So log, add, and we have to pass two parameters. So 1, 2, right? Now if I run this, I will get obviously 3. Not a problem, right? So obviously we are getting two variables, and we are adding, and then we are returning the value, and we are printing. We got the answer, right? Now if I check this type of, so if I see type of, now this is going to be of number, obviously, right? So adding two values is going to give me a number type. Now assume that someone comes new into the project and he doesn't know about your function, that it should pass only two number data type. Instead of that, what that person is doing is he is going to lock using add, and he is going to pass a digit and a string type. Okay, now if I print this, what should happen? Obviously I will get the value as 1 here, right? Because we know that whenever you are going to perform a plus operation, that is addition operation or concatenation in string with number, it is going to convert the data type into string, right? Now if I check this type as well, so here obviously I will get this as string data type, right? So here getting string data type. So this is a major concerns in JavaScript, where you cannot say what is the data type should be. It is dynamic in nature, so whenever you are going to pass parameters, you should always cautious like what you have to actually pass. Of course we can write documentation and we can maintain, but it is not always possible, right? So someone comes new to the project, obviously they might do some mistakes like that. So that is the reason TypeScript is most preferred. Now I'm going to create the same thing in TypeScript and then we'll talk about it. Okay, so first thing first, we have to do the installation. For that I'm going to say npm I and install, or I, you can use anything, both are same. And here I'm going to say dash g, and here I'm going to say TypeScript. Okay, so I already have TypeScript, so this won't take very much time, so it should be done quickly. Okay, so here we got the updated, and the latest version is 3.8.3. okay, in the next video we will learn about TypeScript in detail. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.